I can remember one of the first times I ever did DMT, the day afterwards, like I had this completely different view of the world that I had to sort of apply now, all these other, and like figure out like, do all these factors that I've considered as being important, how many of them am I going to throw out? Like the way I described it is like, my computer rebooted and now only has one folder on the desktop. And that folder is labeled my old bullshit. And so now I have to open this folder and go, okay, how much of this is valid?
Right.
Like, Jesus, this is my whole thought process. This is my whole mind. Mm-hmm. This is how I interface with reality. Unfortunately, some of it made its way back in, you know, and then, you know, I had to do another trip, you know, a few months later, and then I threw out more of it. And it was a sort of a deliberate process of reevaluation.
You can't reject it all. There's some good stuff in that folder.
Right.
But I think what the DMT experience, the psychedelic experience does, you know, that's partly what it does. I like your analogy of the folder, because now you're looking at the folder from the desktop. You're outside the folder.
Yes.
You know, so it's liberated you. You were imprisoned in the folder before. Now you can look at it from the outside and you can go through and say, oh, you know, delete, delete, delete. Oh, this is good. Let's keep this.
Yeah.
You know, let's integrate it. So, you know, ultimately this is a process of, you know, personal cleansing, both physically and emotionally in your, and, you know, psychologically in your encounters with these things, but also cultural cleansing. You know, I mean, there are good memes out there and there are good things going on, but there's so much noise, there's so much bullshit. It's hard to sort out what's worth preserving and what needs to be dispensed with.